Elam is more than just a school. It's a family. You meet people who have the same vision as you that are ready to work. When I first stepped in here, I felt like this, I don't know how to explain it, but I felt this rush of, right, this is it, right? This is where you need to knuckle down. This place is not just about you yourself. You use others to improve your craft as well as theirs. So it's just more family oriented than anywhere else.
Unheard, unplayed. My name is Swazi McKelly. I'm a radio presenter at KISS. I host The Breakfast Show on a Saturday and Sunday morning. I also host over at 4 Music, and I'm the voice of BBC Sounds, music, radio, podcasts. Over 3 days, you are gonna have a small insight into the incredible talent here at East London Arts and Music. Over the past 2 years, these students have worked through some of the toughest times the creative industries have ever, ever known, and are here now to show you just how talented they are. For those of you who don't know what Elam is an incredible free academy for 16 to 19 year olds, designed by the creative industries to get anyone from any background, working in the industries they are passionate about. Today, you're going to get to see the unseen films and stories that represent young people all across London. After this premiere, please click the website link below to see more of the incredible work from our trainees, and let's use this platform as an A&R tool to celebrate and show the world the incredible work here at Elam. You guys are gonna chop it up with me today, so I'm so excited to be joined by George, Cade, Faith, and Cammy. Where did your inspiration come from? Because this whole year has been very wild. This whole pandemic, I'm sure there's been inspiration moments all over the place. So where does your inspiration come from and how does it feed into your work?
Well, I mainly focus in music videos and I love music, but I love filming. So it's the way I can combine both and get the best of both worlds. And like every single day is a different day. Like even if we're doing like a weekend shoot, no day will be the same, like new cast, like everything.
So Cade, who have you enjoyed working with this year and what kind of collaborations have come that wouldn't have come had you not been here at Elam?
Well, if I didn't go to Elam, I don't think I'd be doing music videos in the first place.
Really?
I literally, before I came here, I wasn't really sure what I wanted to do, if I wanted to be in front of the camera, behind the camera. And I reckon one of the best collaborations I've had was doing BTS at some bigger shoots, like, because when I was there I saw the levels that I can reach and like the levels I'm at now and just like the steps on how to get there. So I've been shadowing a few bigger directors and like mastering my photography and color grading and all that as well at the same time.
Persuasion, sweet one, yeah, I got looking like pretty and Priya. I never pull up, bitch, showing no face, but I'm letting this thing like Sia. They all know who we are, we really do war like it's North Korea. I got dead tech customer service, wanna do this bag and sell IKEA. Get me on the glide, watch me ruin this fabric, me and Kappa, big D's in the fiber. They recognize me for the corn and flake, even more than Tony the Tiger. I'm all over the map like Dora, watch for the fence, should I swipe like Swiper. Hop on the ride and got him, always see him again, give another reminder. I told bro, pass that smoke like I smoked cigarette and I wanted a twos. I swear this really ain't no beef, I'm just hopping out rides in his soul of shoes. I got pies calling out man's name in the trap, cause they really trying to abuse their views. I can't ever go back to the wing, no way, where I gotta hide my phone from screws. Won't ever go back for a strip search, only one of youngin' who knows how the flip work. Bitch, one of these juice that I itch first, hop on the rides, see all of them disperse. In jail, no weapons, this fist work, man down to both of them. sir, it was just shh, or it was shh. I don't know which one that we did worse. Everybody rap their spoke for the views. You wanna dive through for a playlist? Come a long way from jail scraps, come a long way from covers and basic. I don't care if a boy's Goliath. Fling two in his head like David. They're gonna swap our squad, come up out and just shell it in public places. Still let it crash in secret. Couldn't give a fuck who knows who heard. And me and these niggas ain't beefing. Didn't stop rhyming offensive words. They knew it was sex who done it. It could have been first, second or third.
Cammy, let me start with you and go back down to George. What are you working on now, and plug your socials?
So I'm a cinematographer and screenwriter, and one thing we're doing right now is a final major project. Mm-hmm. So we were given the brief it was great because it was such a wide brief. It was basically like, you need to meet
you can do anything.
You need to meet a time limit of 8 minutes and that's it, go nuts.
Wow.
You know? But we did a short film that's about 10 minutes long. Mm-hmm. It's called It Always Comes Out in the Wash, and it's about two men of color and their relationship. And we wanted to really emphasize just sort of men's emotions, like talk about how men process their own emotions, specifically towards grief and losing loved ones.
Mm-hmm. Hi, I'm Olo O'Callaghan. My pronouns are they, them, and I'm the trainee president at East London Arts and Music. I'm the director of the production company NA Media, and our FMP was a short film called It Always Comes Out in the Wash. As a college, over the last year, we've experienced a lot of loss. And we've seen how different people have responded to that and how different people have grieved. And we wanted to tell a story of how an underrepresented population see and experience loss, and also give young black men an opportunity to be intimate with each other and feel in front of the camera.
Janelle.
Oh,
God, Janelle's pain.
No. It wasn't even like that. It ain't even like that, you know. Do you know what it is? We tried, innit? But it didn't really go.
Tried, didn't it?
Yeah. Move, man.
Nah, I get it.
I think it's because she kind of reminded me of my mum. Do you know like that? It's mad, innit?
Nah, that's mad, but to be honest, your mum's fit though. So like,
wait, get that for me.
Oh, you lazy prick.
So outside of college, I actually shoot music videos as well. We kind of like formed a group, so we have to kind of create a production team, and within that team we all decided to shoot our own music videos, and we all kind of linked up, said we're going to start this group, and then I kind of decided to make this film. The film was with a client that I've worked with outside of college, we decided that we're going to do this video, and it could also be a part of my FMP while working outside of school as well. So yeah, it was pretty cool that I was able to be like tied in to my FMP as well. So
it's about making dope, put your hands in the air if you're making dope. It's about making dope, got a girl by my side, she Jamaican, bro. It's about making dope, I couldn't give a toss by the bacon, bro. It's about making dope, got a pen and paper, spray, yo. It's about making dope, put your hands in the air if you're making dope. It's about making dope, got a girl by my side, she Jamaican, bro. It's about making dope, I couldn't give a toss by the bacon, yo. It's about making dope, got a pen and paper, spray. Listen, they won't lock us, they won't stop us, but the grind don't stop, we gotta prosper. Indie cheese got a lot to offer. Don't ask a question, say no to coppers. They won't lock us, they won't stop us, but the grind don't stop, we gotta prosper. Indie cheese got a lot to offer. Don't ask a question, say no to coppers. Wanna know what I do for my people? I die for my people, shoot for my people. See, this world is a world for the evil.
So outside of college, I hopefully wanna go on to be a music video director and start my own video production company. But leading on from college, I want to work with some different like film companies, kind of get myself into the industry and branch out on my knowledge.
Wish that I'd sail the darkened seas on a great big clipper ship, going from this land here to that on a sailor's suit and cap. it's my wife and it's my life. Because a mana to my vein leads to a center.
My name's Freya and I'm in Year 12 film and I'm currently doing my final major project. My film is about a 16-year-old girl called Charlotte. It's her 16th-year-old birthday and her mother is really annoyed at her. And the story follows Charlotte as she endures her mum's rage and she tries to rebuild their relationship.
A school in Bristol has become the first in the city to adopt a new policy about students' hair. The Halo Code has been introduced at Brunel Academy. It allows pupils from African and Caribbean backgrounds to wear their hair as they choose. We've been finding out what a difference it's made.
I grew up in a predominantly white area, Worthing, before I moved to London. So I was always aware of race, always aware of my differences and differences to my friends.
My parents did mention that I would probably like experience like racism like to do with my actual skin colour, but they never actually like told me that I would experience like things like texturism, because I thought like racism only applied to like the actual colour of your skin. I didn't think that like it applied to your hair.
When I walked into school with a new hairstyle, I was kind of excited.
One part of you is really excited because you get to show off looking pretty cool and your friends are usually like, oh yeah, your hair looks nice. But then there was another part where you have to like be mentally prepared for a teacher or someone in like an authority position being like, your hair's certainly unique or like interesting.
So I remember I walked into school and I remember like this girl, she was white, she came up to me and she said, is that your real hair or is that a weave? So I didn't know whether that was a compliment, but personally I took it a bit offensive because it's like, why is it that there's this idea that black women can't have long hair? Why is there an idea that black women can only achieve good hair through wigs and weaves? It's just not true.
People always ask me how long my real hair is. They ask me like, what do you put in your hair? Or they'll make comments about how it smells and things like that. But I don't think they were trying to be rude, but it did make me feel very uncomfortable.
I mean, asking how long it takes to do is fine, but then saying, oh, your hair must be really nappy, or it must be really hard to comb through. I could never go through something like that, or I don't think I could ever handle having hair like yours, or your hair's blocking my view. Then move.
These girls were like commenting about my hair, like whispering to each other, and said that my hair was wild, that I needed to comb it, and that I didn't know how to look after my hair.
People do assume personality and who you are based on your hairstyle. I've gotten comments where when I've gotten my braids or my plastic, as some people would like to say, that I turn into a whole new person. Names like Sharkeesha and Shaniqua were definitely thrown out there. So I guess whenever you get a new hairstyle, you're certainly perceived differently.
Yo, 25 rats to the whack, don't tell them. Mm-mm. Swinging my arms since felt them. Whack so hard that his brethren failed him. Nice singing like Wesley Nelson, in there for paper. I ain't no raver still. Spending in Barry like Neymar. Young and confined, so he got the shaver. Cheat with the Smith, I ain't talking about Jada. I don't even need an army, even with my auntie. Still I got an army, I could pot smoke. Wasn't welcome to the party. All this money, but ain't Illuminati. 95 racks ain't slipping, it's round me. Now that I'm up, got brothers in Saudi. Chilling the road, but riding the Audi. And she's saying there's something about me.
25 racks in this Hugo boss.
Mom, just look at me.
My boss. How? Smiles on the cut up, bro. Still piss any time and loss. I'm fucking playing to talk my boss, but still don't really wanna pay that cost. How you gonna talk my floss? 200k, I ain't giving a
day. I've been Swazi here at Elam talking all things unseen, unheard, unplayed. Catch us next time and follow us on all the socials. We'll see you soon.